coach. Thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And no chance to get away as they get him down at about the 17-yard line. The attention shifting back to Chris Godwin and the rest of the Tampa offense.
They have to like what they've gotten from him in this game.
Think about the accumulation of catches.
Eight.
The yards per catch now, because you're getting more than a first down every time he's touching the ball. This is the kind of game you want when you're able to throw it out wide.
Absolutely. Over 100 yards, has the eight catches.
Here, first and 10
at their own 17-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady, he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be climbing right on the 40-yard line. Fresh out of the game of over 20.
I tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. These guys have been taking advantage of it.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line.
We got three.
Brady gonna fake the give to Jones and set up to throw.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing now is Brady. This one swung out here to Jones. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second down. Looks like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy on the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now you got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
Working with second and five now.
Again, it's Brady.
So here's a first and 10 now, down inside the 20.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw, but the man won't just get complete. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles, all passes, all completions, and just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
To throw again on second down. Brady. That's complete. And maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain this time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
Cowboys here on third down, bringing in an extra defensive back. Brady again.
Vanderish. Oh! Brought down by Randy. Who you be that?
On all the interceptions and more incompletions, it just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Jones. He is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the run. He tried to break that plane but couldn't get there, and that's going to leave him now at third and goal. Big play, if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Now they head out for their first possession of
of the second half. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You got to be careful right here.
The final Edwards in 1995 in the 18th round.
Well, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
I think he gunned down a few guys.
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Reed to throw again. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Brady. Touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Extra point try now for Sucker. Comes the Cowboys punter. On, we think, to punt, though he's faked it earlier. But he's been, look at this, another fake. And he's going to let it go deep. Oh, but this is going to backfire as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10, and a good turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, if you're ever going to try to fake punt, this would seem to be the place to do it, but
it doesn't work out.
Yeah, you got to make sure you throw it to your guys and not the other team. But yes, in this spot on the field, only needing a few yards for a first, I think that decision was okay and spot on. The problem was the execution. It was not.
The attention shifting back to Chris Godwin and the rest of the Tampa offense.
All right, so let's look at these numbers. I don't want to read the tea leaves here too much, but maybe he's in his own head a little bit after that hot start to cool off.
Sometimes that happens, and this is where you get tested as a player in this league if you truly want to be an impact player or a star, because that's what they're going to face each and every game. Extra coverage, extra people. So now, do you fight through it? Do you find other ways? Or do you allow it to affect you to the point where you're no longer an impact on the game?
So after the INT, it's Brady. Not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Brady. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
Well, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third down coming up. Back to your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for this. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Looking to throw. Brady. That's outside. Complete. And he's going to have the box first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. The delay, Jones. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Second down, another shot for Jones. This has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10.
Sometimes with the running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ballgame. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Can't get away, and Brady will go down. Across the sack to Leighton Vander Esch. Remember, he had the interception earlier. Now he adds the sack. He's really making his presence felt out there.
Oh, he is putting together a heck of a game. In fact, he's going to bump these plays to his highlight reel. Okay, so when he wants to show it off later on, look what I did out there, guys. And this offense, they've got to start paying him a little special attention. He's like a good basketball player, putting stats in every column.
Here's Bradley Pinion now.
as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. This is fielded at the 7. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? And for the third time tonight, it's an interception. It's Devin White, the linebacker. It's a great shot. He brings it back to the house. What are you doing? Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
That's it. Head coach Armini is putting in Dak Prescott. Unbelievable.
Suck him for the extra point. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six, they'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Return Tony Pollard for his end zone. This one will come out to the 25 as Pollard is going to elect not to return it. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and if I would kept having a rough patch, he said, but you got to do something to make it pass. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Again, it's Elliott. He's got some great to move. He slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 43 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Depends on the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he's struggling, especially that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Now it's the backup, Prescott. Left side here, and it's complete.
The coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. Didn't get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
On 2nd and inches, Prescott. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. The Dallas passing game definitely in sync. They've got another first down. Tim Kennedy out for Apple. Takes this to the 32. 32, maybe the 31. Defensively, they rally quickly after the broken tackle. Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.